Our next presenters are Min Sun and Clover Codd, our first duet. And the title of their talk is, Can Big Data Help Foster a More Culturally Responsive Teaching Workforce?
Today, white teachers make up 80% of the teacher workforce in Seattle Public Schools, yet 53% of our students are students of color. This diversity gap, if you will, leads us to reimagine how to think about the recruitment and retention of a more diverse, culturally responsive workforce.
We know from compiling research evidence about two things. First, teachers are the most important in-school factor that influences students' learning, and no school reform can be successful without them. Second, a diverse teacher workforce benefits all students, particularly students of color, both academically and social-emotionally. Teachers of color serve as positive role models by breaking down negative stereotypes and prepare our students to work and live in a multiracial society.
Informed by this research, Seattle Public Schools is initiating a comprehensive set of reforms, all aimed at attracting, developing, and retaining a culturally responsive workforce. Recruitment alone is not the answer. Recruitment cannot be separated from our approach to teacher induction, and how we develop our teachers is deeply connected to the retention of our educators. I'd like for you to imagine two teachers for a moment, Kyle and Anna. Kyle is a first-year teacher. He was a paraprofessional in our school district who showed a promise and passion for teaching. He entered into our Academy for Rising Educators Grow Your Own program and is now one of over 200 first-year teachers in Seattle Public Schools. Now I'd like for you to meet Anna. Anna is a consulting teacher, a master educator. She is on special assignment from her classroom for an entire year, working with Kyle in a one-on-one situation. They discuss instructional strategies every other week and how to better meet the needs of the students in Kyle's classroom. Their conversations are guided by our foundational coursework, which creates a coherent and common vision for culturally responsive practices and expert teaching throughout our district. Kyle and Anna discuss concepts such as implicit bias and how racism plays out in schools and in classrooms. They look at student data through the lens of racial equity and discuss how to better meet the individual needs of Kyle's students. Together, they work to create a joyful classroom where all students are allowed to be their authentic selves and engage in rigorous learning.
With this strong partnership, in the past 3 years, we have been working side by side using research and data to drive the iteration of those initiatives. When you hear about big data, you may immediately think about tech companies, biomedical research. The truth is that our education system generates the most comprehensive, bigger data than any company, yet we have not been systematically using them. In our partnership, we're not only utilizing conventional data that schools and districts have long collected on our students, parents, and teachers, we also co-design innovative measures and collect through surveys, observations, and activity logs. In addition, we use text as a data methods and other cutting-edge technology to analyze reports and open-ended survey responses so that we can provide timely and detailed information that can actually drive change. There is really no point of collecting data if we don't use them, and we cannot wisely use them if we don't know what questions to ask and how to use the information we extract from the data to inform our theory of change. The leverage of our partnership is that we can unite content experts, teachers, school leaders, and district policymakers, as well as data scientists, to tackle these complex data use issues. Our partnership proved that data and research can not only identify tipping points for change, but also drive innovations to support Anna and Cal's instructional improvement, and also to support district-level system change.
This partnership allows us to monitor the implementation of our strategies and adjust our efforts in real time.
In this endeavor together, research and practice partnership stands as our best chance to use research and data to drive positive change.
Thank you.